In this video, I'm going to explain pathway of corticospinal tract. Corticospinal tract is a pathway of nerve. Especially corticospinal tract is motor pathway. This part organizes what kind of movement you want to accomplish. Then brain sends information to skeletal muscle. Then you can accomplish movement. Let me explain this part first, this red part. This is primary motor cortex. Main function is voluntary movement. First thing first, primary motor cortex sends information, okay? Now here's important thing. You see red color all over the hemisphere, especially this segment. This part of primary motor cortex controls about lower extremity. Okay, this part is lower extremity. About this part is upper extremity. And rest of the part is face. Lower extremity, upper extremity, and face. Okay. By the way, this is left hemisphere. Then brain sends information to skeletal muscle. Left hemisphere goes to right side of the body. Right hemispheres go to left side of the body. Okay? I am going to explain left hemisphere. Then where is pathway of this corticospinal tract? Let me explain that. Here is caudate nucleus, and you see kind of a random pathway here. This part is internal capsule. Internal capsule is like kind of L-shaped structure. Many pathways pass in internal capsule. Imagine this is L-shape. Corticospinal tract travels about this part, around corner and posterior part, about this part. Now, the part of face passes anterior part, okay? And upper extremity passes posterior to face. Then lower extremity passes about here. It's very tiny segment. Face is close to this corner. Upper extremity and lower extremity. So how to remember is his head, upper extremity and lower extremity. It's like a person is standing up, okay? Head, upper extremity and lower extremity. Imagine this is left hemisphere, corticospinal tract, and it passes in internal capsule. Then where is that going? Corticospinal tract passes in internal capsule. Come here, and it travels here. Cerebral peduncle. This is part of midbrain. It passes anterior part of midbrain. Okay, it keeps traveling. This is medulla oblongata. 70-80% of corticospinal tract crosses here at this level. Again, this is left hemisphere. Left hemisphere, internal capsule, cerebral peduncle, left side, then crosses to right side. So if right side is traveling, now crosses to left side. About 70-80% of fibers cross here. Rest of 20-30% fiber crosses at level of spines. Let's say if you want to move your upper extremity, about 20-30% crosses at level of cervical spines because brachial plexus, which innervates upper extremity, emerge from cervical spines. Okay. Again, let's review from cerebral level. This is left hemisphere. This part controls lower extremity. This part controls upper extremity. This part controls face. This is left hemisphere. It goes to internal capsule, then crosses to right side. Left side, primary motor cortex. This is internal capsule. It's L-shaped structure, L-shaped pathway. There are many pathways passing in internal capsule. Corticospinal tract travel about level of corona and posterior part. Close to corona, the face part passes. Here, the posterior from face, this is upper extremity part. The most posterior part is lower extremity. It's like a human form, you know, person is standing up. Okay? Now, it keeps traveling. This is anterior part, cerebral peduncle, then crosses at level of medulla. Other 20 or 30% crosses at level of spines, okay? You know, corticospinal tract is very important to understand motor function and for clinical experience. Like, what happens if hemorrhage happens here? That can aggravate corticospinal tract. That can lead paralysis, numbness, motor dysfunction. Then what happens if hemorrhage happens here, about here, or about here? You know, understanding this pathway can apply to clinical experience. I know it's very hard, so I just want to keep it simple and very visual way. So I hope this video helps your understanding of corticospinal tract. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.